A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "A rich man had a steward who was reported to him for squandering his property. He summoned him and said, 'What is this I hear about you? Prepare a full account of your stewardship, because you can no longer be my steward.' The steward said to himself, 'What shall I do now that my master is taking the position of steward away from me? I am not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. I know what I shall do, so that when I am removed from the stewardship, they may welcome me into their homes.' He called his master's debtors one by one. To the first he said, 'How much do you owe my master?' He replied, 100 measures of olive oil.' He said to him, 'Here is your promissory note. Sit down and quickly write 1 for 50. Then to another he said, 'And you, how much do you owe?' He replied, 100 cores of wheat. He said to him, 'Here is your promissory note. Write 1 for 80. And the master commended that dishonest steward for acting prudently. For the children of this world are more prudent in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light." The Gospel of the Lord. Dishonest steward. Pope Francis offers many insights on the figure of the dishonest steward. He notes that corrupt managers are worshippers of the goddess of bribery, and they commit a grave sin against dignity, and even give tainted bread to their own children. This worldly cunning should be countered with Christian cunning, which is a gift of the Holy Spirit. The Lord speaks to us about the spirit of the world of worldliness, and how this worldliness operates, and how dangerous it is. For Francis, worldliness is the enemy. It means living according to the world's values, and this lifestyle so delights the devil. The bribery mentality is a worldly habit that's very wrong. Francis notes that it begins with a small kickback, but it's like a drug. Even if the first kickback is small, then comes another and another, and it ends in the illness of being addicted to bribery. With Pope Francis, we pray that the Lord will change the hearts of those who worship the goddess of bribery. We also pray that we ourselves may live with clean hands and hearts.